10 style tips for women over 40, guaranteed to elevate all of your looks. But honestly, no matter what your age, I promise these style tips will help you look like the best version of yourself every single day. These are tips that I do all the time. I honestly practice most of them literally almost every single day. So if you would please hit that little subscribe button, I would truly appreciate it. I do publish 2 new videos every single week, and I did start my channel a little over 2 years ago to help women just like you look and feel confident, but more importantly, look and feel like the best versions of themselves. So I want to thank Ana Luisa for sponsoring this video. They are one of my favorite online jewelry stores. I'm in love with all of their pieces, and I'm going to be featuring 4 pieces from Ana Luisa today in this video. But please make sure you listen to this entire video, because tip number 10 is definitely the most important tip. I think it will save you time. I think it will save you money. I think that you will absolutely love it. I know that when I learned this tip, it literally changed the way I thought about shopping and I thought about dressing. So I cannot wait to share tip number 10 with you guys. Okay, tip number 1 is don't skip on accessories. Really, accessories make any outfit. They can take a very, you know, simple, basic white tee and pair of denim to the next level if you have on some fabulous, you know, stacked necklaces and some really beautiful rings like I have on here from Ana Luisa. So first I'm going to talk about this really cool paper clip chain necklace. It's sort of the collarbone length necklace, which I absolutely love. It does have a really cool clasp in the back, so you could actually wear the clasp in the front or in the back. I chose to wear it in the back. It looks amazing alone, but I think it also looks really fabulous layered with my gold coin necklace, which is also from Ana Luisa. So it's just beautiful. I think these two pieces really layer just beautifully together. But again, you can wear them separate, but I always love wearing them together because I think it makes more of a statement when you layer sort of these really beautiful gold necklaces together. One amazing thing is you guys are all going to get a discount that'll be linked down below in my description box from Ana Luisa. Also, these pieces are very affordable. I'm pretty sure every piece is under $100, so what a great deal. And as well, all of the items that I'm talking about in today's video will be linked down below in my description box. But all of these pieces can be worn with every single look in this video. As you will see, I'm wearing them with most of the outfits featured in this video, proving their versatility and wearability, which is why I'm such a big fan of Ana Luisa jewelry. So let's talk about these beautiful rings for a moment. So this one is a really cool gold bubble ring. I love rings. I think this one is cool because it's simple, it's minimal, but it's also very chic and just very beautiful, and I think just very statement making. Now this one has some beautiful stones on it that look like diamonds. They honestly look like real diamonds, but because you know they're not real, then the price point is still very affordable and very budget friendly. But I think it really looks more expensive than it really is. So I loved wearing the bubble ring on the index finger, and then this ring on the middle on the ring finger. But certainly you could play around with it. You know, maybe wear this one on the middle finger or whatever. But I just love these rings. I always love wearing rings and necklaces. I'm not a big lover of bracelets. If you can't tell, they kind of bother me. So I don't really wear bracelets too often. So. Anyways, definitely don't skip on the accessories, and always remember to just add some beautiful layered jewelry to all of your looks, because I promise it will take them to the next level. Tip number 2 to elevate your looks is to have fun with fashion and to step out of the box every once in a while. So like I said, fashion is meant to be fun. It's a way you can express yourself to feel good about yourself. So I can kind of get in a rut. I'm very minimal. I like, you know, neutral colors. I like solids. I hardly ever wear prints. But on occasion, I'll say to myself, you know what? Why don't you just have some fun and wear a fun print? So for me, wearing prints is, you know, kind of stepping out of my box a little bit. So the first outfit I want to feature wearing a print is this beautiful zebra denim jacket. It is by Retrofit, which is one of my favorite brands that Revolve carries. Actually, it's carried, I think, at Neiman Marcus and Nordstrom as well. But just beautiful, high quality pieces. I thought this zebra jacket was really kind of cool and edgy, which matches my style perfectly. This jacket is a bit oversized, so it's very fashion forward and very on trend, because one of the biggest trends we're seeing in 2021 are oversized jackets. But this one is cool. I love it because it's denim, so it's kind of casual. You could easily throw on a pair of white sneakers with this outfit and be super casual. But I just love the zebra print, and it also animal print, whether that's zebra print or leopard, is also going to be very big this fall and winter in 2021. And what I paired it with is this fabulous body contour camisole from Express. It is cropped, but because I paired it with these amazing Express high-waisted jeans, which are under $100, by the way, you know, you're not going to be showing any skin as long as you pair this little crop top with the high-waisted denim. But I love the material of the top. It's soft. It's wrinkle-free. This is just an excellent basic that you can literally wear underneath all of your jackets this fall and winter. I will also link just a regular black cami as well as a regular black bodysuit in case the crop top isn't for you. I totally get that. But let's talk about these jeans for a moment. They are my favorite new jeans. I love this just very elegant and simple black wash. They do have a bit of distressing, a little rip in them, which makes them a bit edgy. So again, that really matches my style. They are the new silhouette for denim in 2021, meaning they are a high-waisted, slim, straight leg jean. So very on trend, very, you know, sort of fashion forward in terms of the denim trend right now. So love them, very slim. They're going to make your legs look crazy long because they are high-waisted. Plus, they're just going to do a great job of holding everything in. So I cannot recommend Express denim enough. It honestly fits like designer denim, but it's a fraction of the price. Okay, another thing that took me out of my comfort zone was the biker shorts. And in fact, in my last video, I asked you guys if y'all wanted me to style biker shorts tons of ways. And the most people said, Heather, oh my gosh, you cannot wear biker shorts out on the street. Like, that is not elegant. That is not chic. And I totally agree with you. So the only place I would wear biker shorts is, you know, to exercise. Obviously, if I'm going to walk my dog, if I'm going to a workout class or something like that, or if I'm just gonna like go run errands or grab coffee with a girlfriend after I work out or go to yoga, that's when I would wear the biker shorts. So I did pick these up from Bandeer. This is a set, a black pair of biker shorts. They are ribbed, so I think they're a bit more flattering than just say a smooth black spandexy material. They came with a matching ribbed bra top, and then I topped it with a really cool leather jacket by Lamarck. So this is just, again, a casual outfit. I took my yoga wear and I added the leather jacket. I put on the hat and some fun, amazing sneakers. These are by Zadig and Voltaire, by the way. They're kind of a really cool dad sneaker. So again, I would not wear this out to dinner. I would not wear this like when I'm trying to dress up, but when I'm just gonna go work out and just be like very casual, very easy. This is just sort of a sporty chic look that I love, and I did wanna step out of my comfort zone and try the biker shorts. So here it is, you either like it or you hate it, and whichever one, that's fine. You're entitled to your own opinion. Okay, tip number three in order to elevate your looks is don't worry about sizing. The main thing to keep in mind is that the clothes look beautiful on you and that they hug your curves in all the right places. So if you have to go up a size, so what? Like, it's not a big deal. Nobody's gonna know but you. Nobody sees the tag. Nobody sees the size. So in order for something to look, you know, amazing on you, just get the right size. And I always do this. Sometimes I'll order extra small and small, you know, or whatever, because I don't know what's going to look best on me. And if I had the mindset of, oh my gosh, I'm only going to wear extra smalls, and if I have to wear a small, then I'm just not going to do it. Like, no, who cares? It doesn't matter if I'm what size you are, or what size I am. What matters is that the clothes lay beautifully and they really accentuate my best features. So I do that a lot, so that's a tip for you. If you're ordering something online, you're not sure what size you might need, order both sizes, try them on, and then you will see which one looks best on you. And don't worry so much about the size, because it honestly doesn't matter. So case in point, this beautiful Good American dress, it's a leopard midi dress, again, sort of stepping out of my comfort zone with this leopard print, but this dress is very flattering. It is very form fitting. So I took the 0 and the 1 back to the dressing room thinking to myself, I sort of caught myself thinking, oh, well, I hope that I'm the 0, but then no, I tried them both on. The 0 was way too tight. The 1 is still pretty form fitting, but it fit me much better. So again, I had to get that out of my head, like who cares what size you're gonna buy, just buy the one that looks the best on you. So that's what I did, and that's my advice for you as well. But I love this Good American dress. The price point is very reasonable. It's very flattering. I topped it with a beautiful Balmain blazer. I love this blazer so much, and it also looks really cool with a leather jacket topped over it. My photographer actually snapped this candid shot in my living room a couple weeks ago when we were shooting this dress with my Chic at Every Age group, and I had on the leather jacket with it. But then I traded the leather jacket for the blazer for the Chic at Every Age shoot. So as you can see, this beautiful leopard dress can be styled so many different ways. It's incredibly chic, the perfect date night or girls night out dress. So it's just fabulous, highly recommend it. Okay, tip number 4 is to accentuate your best feature. So what is your best feature? I ask you that, and I also ask you to leave it down below in my description box. Tell me what you love about yourself. I always think that's important for us to think, you know, in a positive mindset. Think about things that we love about ourselves and what makes us beautiful on the inside and on the out. Because if we focus on the negative, that can really play, you know, a significant part in our attitude towards life. So let's try to always focus on the positive. So that's why I want to hear from all of you. What is your favorite feature on your body? What do you love about your body? So for me, I really love just sort of my hourglass, you know, my hourglass figure, my stomach, and just sort of how it curves in right there. So I always love wearing form-fitting dresses. That's like one of my favorite things to wear because I think it really accentuates my figure. So this is a beautiful brown halter dress from Revolve. I love this color. We're seeing a lot of browns, chocolate browns, beiges, tans, earth tones, and even like that rust color is just going to be really big for fall this 2021. So the color of this dress is just very on point. I think it hugs my curves in all the right places. I love this sexy sort of halter top neckline. I think it's amazing. I would wear this dress alone, but I think it looks very chic as well with like a white leather jacket draped over it. I'm going to be going to dinner this weekend with some friends, and I think this is exactly what I'll be wearing. Okay, tip number 5, don't ignore your undergarments when you're wearing something, especially a form-fitting dress or a midi skirt or something like that that's form-fitting. Always wear Spanx. So I always wear Spanx. You know, I have them on right now with this really beautiful green dress. I had them on with that brown dress earlier. I just think they do a great job of holding everything in. And if you're going to put on a beautiful outfit, you know, just finish it off. Pay attention to the detail of your undergarments. And I just think Spanx make the biggest difference. So I have 2 pair that I recommend. One covers a little bit more than the other. One comes up literally right below your boobs and hits you right above the knee. I would say these will honestly make you look like at least like 5 to 10 pounds slimmer. I swear by them. I absolutely love them. They just suck everything in and tighten everything up. So they just do a great job of making you look like the best version of yourself. Now, sometimes if a dress has a slit up the side, then I can't wear the longer Spanx. So then I'll wear the shorter Spanx. They come in nude. They come in black. But I honestly just love the way I look when I have the Spanx on. So highly recommend them. Now, up top, I'm going to be honest, I just wear the nipple covers because I did have breast implants probably 20 years ago and I don't need to wear a bra. So I'm just going to put it all out there, be completely honest with you. So that's what I wear up top. Now, if you aren't, you know, if you don't have implants or if you need to wear a bra, like totally get that. Just make sure you wear a bra that fits you properly. I would recommend, I love Soma bras. They're my favorite bras. So when I do wear a bra, I wear Soma bras. I went in not long ago to Soma and had a bra fitting, and I highly recommend it because I was actually wearing the wrong bra size before I did that. So just make sure you wear the correct size in undergarments. And remember, just pay attention to those and don't skip on them because they really will make an outfit just look better. So with the Spanx that I have on, I'm wearing this beautiful green dress. Actually, it's not the green dress that I'm wearing right now. This green dress is by Wisely. I think that's the way you say it, W-S-L-Y. This brand is really cool. It's sold at Bandeer. It's sold at Revolve. This dress comes in multiple colors. I actually have it in gray as well. But I wanted to show y'all what it looked like styled during the day and then into the nighttime. So during the day, I just wear some simple Chloe slides in an easy crossbody bag. This is just like a super casual look. Run to the grocery store, run to meet your mom for lunch or a girlfriend or something like that. Like very casual, but also very stylish. Then if you're going out to dinner, you could top it with a really cool vest. This amazing and edgy faded black denim vest is also by Retrofit, the same brand that zebra denim jacket was by. I love the broad shoulders. I think it's super cool. It's also very slimming because I do have broad shoulders, and when I put this on, it wasn't like too much, I didn't think. So the shoulders come out, but it creates this beautiful silhouette because it really cuts you in at the waist. So even if you didn't have a waist, it's going to give you a waist. So I just love the fact of how much it accentuates the waistline, making you look slimmer, making you look taller. So absolutely love this vest. I loved it paired over the dress, but I think it would look really cool with denim as well. And then I obviously swapped out the slides for some beautiful gold ankle strap heels. And then I just kept on the same crossbody bag by YSL. But love this date night look. My husband loved it as well. So I think it's just a fabulous dress that can take you from day to night. Tip number 6 is to remember what you wear when you get the most compliments. So whatever that is, maybe you love your legs and it's when you wear shorts, or it's when you wear skirts or dresses that, you know, your legs are showing that you get the most compliments. Maybe it's a certain color that you wear that you get the most compliments. You know, maybe it's, you know, an off-the-shoulder top or a halter top or a blazer, a beautiful chic blazer, like whatever that is for you, remember when you get the most compliments and wear those types of items, because obviously they look the best on you or people wouldn't say so. So let's go back to the color thing. I tend to get more compliments when I wear either blue or green. I don't know why that is. Maybe that's because I typically wear neutral colors or black or white or gray. So when I do wear a bit of color, I do tend to get more compliments. Plus I think blue or green just really brings out my eyes. So I want to feature this beautiful green dress by Jonathan Simkai. I love the neckline. It sort of cuts in at the shoulders. It's like this knit material, so it's ribbed as well, so it's very flattering, it's wrinkle-free. It is so comfortable, like I literally feel like I'm wearing a nightgown. It does look fabulous by itself, just like with these gold, beautiful necklaces from Ana Luisa layered over it, but you could also just throw on a leather jacket, you could throw on a blazer, just to complete the look. You could even take this dress into fall, topping it off with a black leather jacket and maybe some fun fall black booties. But love this dress. I really love the slit up the side as well. Very tastefully sexy and just incredibly chic. I have on my Bottega Veneta gold chain heels as well as the Bottega dupe bag. Now let's talk about this bag for a second. I love the gold chain. I love sort of this pouch clutch style, which is another big trend we're seeing in 2021. But a really cool dupe that I found on the Nordstrom website is by this really neat brand that I just discovered called House of Want. They have the most beautiful faux leather or maybe vegan leather bags actually with gold chains, and I loved this white one with the gold chain. I think it would be beautiful. It does come in black as well, so if you're really on to sort of the fall and winter vibes, if you're focusing on that right now for your wardrobe, I would say go with the black one. But I think you can still certainly wear white in fall and winter, so, and summer isn't over yet, so I think the white one would also be a fabulous addition to your handbag collection. And the price on these is around $100, maybe even less. So very budget friendly, and just what a great deal for such a cool bag. Tip number 7 is to notice yourself in photos and see what you look your best in, and then wear more of that. So I don't know, maybe you go have a girls' night out and you take a photo with a bunch of your girlfriends, and then, you know, you just kind of see like, oh, I love it when I have on a jacket and denim, or maybe I look better in an A-line dress, or maybe I look better in a midi dress, or maybe I look better when I wear shorts. Like whatever it is, notice how you look in photos and go on that depending on what you think you look your best in, because photos don't lie. You know, it's obvious if you see a picture of yourself in something that isn't flattering, crying, well, then maybe you shouldn't wear that the next time, you know, you go out or whatever. So really pay attention to what you look like in photos and then go on that when deciding what to wear. So for me, as I said, I love ring fitted dresses. And when I see myself in photos and fitted dresses, I do like the way I look. So that is why I love wearing fitted dresses. So this beige one is by Jonathan Simkhai. It is long sleeved. I love the cutouts up here. It's also very comfortable. And because it is that really cool sort of thicker ribbed material, it's going to do a great job of sort of holding everything in. But yes, I definitely still have on my Spanx with this form-fitting dress. And I love the color. It's just a beautiful neutral color. Again, anything neutral is just going to look more expensive than it really is. And then I did the same Bottega gold chain heels and that Bottega dupe handbag that I'm loving so much. And again, I'll link the other one from House of Want that's very similar but a fraction of the price. Okay, tip number 8 is be very detail-oriented when you're putting your outfits together and pay attention to details, aka wrinkles, for example. So if something is wrinkled, I would say just don't wear it or steam it out really quick. I do have a steamer by Jiffy, I think. I will link it down below. I've literally had it for 10 years. I couldn't live without it. I pull it out at least once or twice a week when I'm getting dressed because I'll pull a shirt out, maybe that's been crammed in my closet, it's got wrinkles on it. I just steam it out. It literally takes 5 seconds. So highly recommend that. Also, if you have a shirt that has maybe it's pilled or maybe it's stained or something like that, like don't wear it. Just get rid of it or wash it. But don't wear clothes that are wrinkled or stained. It just looks sloppy and it's definitely not going to elevate any of your looks. Okay, tip number 9 is to focus on basics versus trend pieces. So I preach this a lot on my channel and on my blog. Basically, if you have a wardrobe that is made up of, say, I would say at least 80%, maybe even 85% of basics, meaning blazers, you know, camis, midi dresses, you know, a leather jacket, an army jacket, like a white tee, you know, a pair of nude pumps. Like these are things that you must have in your wardrobe in order to make it functional, in order to make it getting dressed for you every single day so much easier. So focus on the basics. I've done tons of posts on capsule wardrobes, which are always filled with basics. I will link that one down below. You know, 10 basics every woman needs in her wardrobe. I will link that one down below because you must have a closet full of basics in order for it to be functional, like I said. And also it will make getting dressed easier for you every single day. So this black blazer, definitely probably number 1 or number 2 on the list would be a black blazer is a basic everyone needs. And a black leather jacket. So talking about the black blazer here in this outfit, this one is by Cinque Set. It is a bit oversized, so very on trend for fall and winter of 2021. I love the fact that the sleeves are already made to look a little pushed up, so you don't have to worry about always pushing them up because that's how I always love to wear my blazers, is with the sleeves pushed up. I just think it's a very effortless and chic way to wear a blazer. So love this blazer. Again, it looks fabulous with denim, but it also looks really cool with shorts because I think that's a great way to wear a blazer in the summertime. And then I did the black, very simple camisole from Express. Again, it is cropped, but because I paired it with these amazing jeans by Katie, you don't see any of my stomach. So these jeans are insane. Like the fit is out of this world. These are expensive jeans, I will say that. I did splurge on them because I just thought they were super cool. I've seen them on tons of like mega influencers and even a few celebrities. So love these jeans. They're super high-waisted. They come way over my belly button. They're very slim fitting and then it's a straight leg. And then of course they have their rips in the knees. I'm comfortable wearing ripped denim. I feel confident in like myself when I wear ripped denim, but I will be linking a pair that is not ripped by A Gold E. That's a great dupe to these jeans in case ripped jeans isn't your thing. I totally get it. I know a lot of women aren't comfortable wearing ripped jeans, but for me personally, I love wearing them. And what I always say is wear what you feel your best in, wear what you feel most confident in. So that is why I love wearing ripped jeans. It's just an easy, effortless outfit. And again, focusing on the basic pieces, which would be the blazer and just the simple camisole, really make this outfit incredibly chic. Okay, tip number 10, the one we've all been waiting for, is to pick out a celebrity or an influencer that is around your same age and around your same size. and someone that you admire and you just are obsessed with their style. And then you just go through their Instagram feed or you go through their Google pictures or Pinterest. Pinterest is a place I love to go and I get a lot of style information. And look at their outfits and look at what they're wearing and how they're putting them together. So my two favorite style icons are Rosie Huntington Whitley. I just did a video and a blog post on dressing similar to Rosie Huntington Whitley. I think I did 8, maybe 10 outfits inspired by her. So I'll show you a couple of those. Love looking at her. I think she has impeccable style. So anytime I'm out shopping, I always kind of think to myself, you know, how would Rosie wear this? So anyway, I think that's just an amazing tip that has really helped me. And I think it could also really help you guys. So I want to talk about two Rosie Huntington Whitley inspired outfits. The first one is this beautiful express blazer. This is satin, so it's going to look way more expensive than it really is. And it is wrinkle-free. It's beautiful. The fit is impeccable. You know, this is also another one of those wardrobe staples. Like I said, a black blazer that is really going to take you far. It's going to take you many places in style because a black blazer is such an essential piece that every woman needs in her wardrobe. And this one is phenomenal. Again, because it's from Express, the price point is amazing. And then I did an Express black bodysuit. Now, this exact black bodysuit is almost sold out, but it does come in a beige color that I just ordered. It's like $35. It's fully stocked. So I will link that one as well, but then I'll also link to another just easy and simple strapless black bodysuit. Then I went with some A Gold E black denim shorts. These are my favorite style of denim shorts because they're high-waisted, plus the inseam is a little bit longer, making them very age-appropriate. So love this look. It's basically an all-black look with a blazer and shorts, just like Rosie, and I was inspired by her, so I sort of dug in my closet, got some items out that she was wearing, put it together, and there you have it. Now, the next Rosie-inspired look is this really cool slip dress by Millie Lowton. Again, a slip dress is another wardrobe basic every woman needs. I love this slip dress because the fit is impeccable. It just lays beautifully over my body. And then I topped it with a tan satin blazer, also from Express, just like Rosie did. I'm sure her blazer isn't from Express, but you get the idea. You don't have to have the same exact item to create a similar look. So I loved just draping this neutral blazer over the black slip dress. Again, another, you know, essential wardrobe basic is a tan blazer. And then I just did some fabulous heels as well. So those were the 10 style tips, sure to elevate all of your looks. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. For more style information, you can head over to SoHeather.com. And on Instagram, I'm SoHeatherBlog. I also want to thank Ana Luisa again for sponsoring this video. Remember, all of their beautiful jewelry will be linked down below in my description box. So thanks again for stopping by today. I truly appreciate each and every one of you. I hope you have a beautiful day. And until next time, I will see you soon. Bye-bye.